Beauty and the Beast is the classic tale of good and evil. In the story, there is a merchant who has three daughters. One of them is called Beauty, and she doesn't share the same views as her other two sisters. The merchant receives news that his ship has come in, laden with treasures. He leaves his daughters to meet with his former business partners and receive his fair share. When he finally reaches the town, he seeks directions to where the offices of his former partners would be. The townspeople tell him, "You can't miss it."
Thank you.
Well, his former partners cheat him out of his portion of the money, and they kick him out into the cold night. He is alone and destitute. What will he do? He'll have to go home to his daughters penniless, with no gifts for them. A failure. The merchant must find shelter. He stops at a strange castle where food and drink is magically set out for him. Who is it that treats him with such wonderful hospitality? He comes upon a beautiful garden with lovely wild roses. He decides to take just one to give to Beauty. A beast appears, a horrible, ugly creature. How dare you steal one of my prize roses? You see, the beast is the owner of this castle. What will I do with this thief? The beast thinks.
Should I rip his head off? Cook him up for lunch? Or put him in a chocolate bar? To get that certain crunch? Maybe I should toast him? Roast it!
The merchant tries to explain he was only taking a rose to give to his daughter. The beast is intrigued. He tries to strike a bargain with the merchant. The beast will spare the merchant's life if he brings one of his daughters to live with him. The merchant says, "I can't do that." The beast replies, "You can't have much interest in living." The merchant is horrified.
"Can you give up your life
for my daughter? What kind of bark is that? I don't think that he plays a man. You can have my land, you can have my house, but my daughter, no, don't you dare. Daughter, no, don't you dare. You can have my land, you can have my house, but my daughter, no, don't you dare." Now that I know that I'm no saint, and I try to do things right.
But the merchant can't ignore the beast, and eventually his daughter Beauty is brought to the beast's castle. She is left there to wake up alone, far from her home, missing her family.
Hello, how are you, Father? No one comes home. It's cold and
The beast makes his appearance. Beauty is terrified. But the beast explains that he only wants her friendship. How can a beast like him have friendship? She remembers what her father said about the beast.
My father said you'd only rip their heads off! Or cook them up for lunch! Or put them in a chocolate bar! To get that certain brunch!
What the heck? What the beast? All I want from the advice is something for my soup!
Well, I don't think it's so much fun to be in some soup! I don't learn more matters!
One night we see the sinister side of the beast's personality, the horrible duty of the beast to his curse.
I am the roar of the thunder.
Sometimes beauty gets tired and bored. There is nothing for her to do. The Beast gets his magical servants, the Sprites, to do a little dance to entertain her. Wicked witch had cast a spell upon a handsome prince and turned him into the Beast. This handsome prince appears to Beauty in her dreams. She is confused and distraught. She falls in love with this dream image. When Beauty is awake, the Beast is constantly and mysteriously asking her to marry him. She refuses, saying she does not love him. But one night when the Beast nearly dies, she runs to him and consents to marry him. The spell is broken. The prince is reborn.
I don't. don't have to be alone. When leaves of autumn fall, we both can have a home. When winter winds blow cold, we'll still be warm inside. We're so close to it now. Take this hand held out to you. We don't have to be alone. So here we are, but where are we? Is this a dream or can it be reality? Can we but reach across the distance and believe? Before we grow too old, we're growing old. Take this love I offer you, and let's begin to live a dream that can come true. Open the door, you'll be amazed what comes in. We don't have to be alone.